a number of us, our heads are highly on demand in this country. I cited on a press conference last week in Laikipia that my life is in danger and that a certain government officer in the name of the deputy governor of Laikipia made some utterances which can only be concluded to death threats, and the same records are with the office of the DCI. And this has continued. Last week on Friday night, my office, Laikipia office, was vandalized, and the people who came and vandalized my office were this experience that the only thing they would obtain were laptops, desktops, and flash disks which were available in the office. There were other variables which were not touched, and the end of it is that my home, my children, my husband, and people around me, we are always surrounded by people we do not understand. And upon raising this matter with police, Nanyuki police station, until to date, no single suspect, including the watchman who is on run, who was taking care of our Nanyuki GAF office or my Nanyuki office, has not been arrested. Very little is being done towards this. I talked about criminal elements which have been used and are continuing to be used by politicians. And some of these people are people who are in this parliament, nominated members of parliament. Others, they lost their seats. And they're using criminal elements to intimidate members of parliament, starting with myself, people who sound not of a similar political opinion in this country. I must say that the 2010 Constitution clearly stipulates about my freedom of movement, freedom of association, and even the way I get to think and even reason. I have not seen anybody who have come and asked me, I want you to help me to decampaign a certain candidate, or I want you to help campaign for a certain candidate, because the president's speech was very clear, and his address to this nation is very clear. Politics aside, and it's time to work. Now, I want to bring to the attention of this country, and also the attention of the president, that there are some people who are gatekeepers, both in our major coalitions and political parties, who do not want to heed to the instructions which he gave. And they are busy doing local politics, county politics, mashinani politics, trying to decampaign individuals who they want to imagine in their thinking and their hallucination that they are not supporting the whatever they believe in. And when I say this, these members of parliament, you saw them come out clearly. There were even issues which were raised in Moranga County. People telling other members, sitting members of parliament, we are going to decampaign you. We want to bring your opponents so that they can fight you because you are of Tanga Tanga movement or because you are of whichever movement it is that people are talking about. And I want to state clearly, as a woman and as a legislator, we do not want to take these threats lightly. We have seen women who have been killed. Literally, this lady called Martha. Until to date, other than these issues which are being brought about abortion, there's no clear evidence which is coming out to tell us, was this something which was used to falsify issues which led to the death of this young woman? And for that reason, we want to ask for security, we want to ask for protection, and we want our political parties, the both coalition leaders, to know there are certain supporters and certain political gatekeepers who are misusing the privilege which they have been given. And people want to presume that they have the attention of the government more than any other Kenyan, that they want to misuse that by making sure that they use criminals and gangs to come and harass us. And I must say, it's such a coward act. If you think you're intimidated by a woman, let's meet at the ballot. You don't need to use guns. Guns and goons will only meet at the ballot when they're voting for one of their own. And history will prove us wrong. We had people who had criminal guns, and they have never even won a single constituency seat. And I also, to our people, our opponents on the ground, people who lost, working towards towards objecting development and issues and matters which we promise to our people, is not going to bring you any relevance. And therefore, these people should be dismissed. If you see people who lost positions and are busy moving around and addressing movements and talking about, CG, we are together. I heard there is another one in Mount Kenya, which is talking of Mount Kenya, and I don't know, exports and imports of diaspora, and I don't know, whatever. We want you to dismiss them and know clearly, some of them, they came out strongly opposing the current government, opposing handshake. It is only now they want to revive themselves, attacking people who they think, because they keep to mention it, laboring us. Who called me a Tanga Tanga? My name is Catherine Wanjiku Waruguru. Who said I'm a Tanga Tanga? I am not. I'm a member of parliament, and I can only propagate ideologies and agendas who I believe to the people I represent, they are of the same opinion. So, members of the Fourth Estate, please, If you help us by telling the nation that parliamentarians are threatened, our families are threatened, we are intimidated, these people are looking for our heads. The other day they said they are even discussing my body, what is sweet and what is not sweet. And I must say, it is backward, it is rhetoric, it does not add any value. If you feel intimidated by the Honorable Baraza, or you feel intimidated by Honorable Ngonjiri, or the woman rep of Laikipia, va marinda tukutane kwa debe if that is what you want. But we cannot allow this. We must be protected.